Lorenzo, Benedict, lovely to meet you. Thanks for chatting to us this morning.
Thank you.
Marco.
Polo.
Am I the first person to do that, or about the millionth person
no,
to do that?
No, first. It's actually the first one. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much.
You've won the prize.
Yeah. Cheers. Thank you.
Where is it?
I get a prize as well and everything.
Yeah, here it is.
What have we got? Oh, you're too kind.
Wonderful strawberry.
That's. I'm going to cherish that for the rest of my life, or at least until lunchtime.
Look, it's wonderfully and sweet.
Thanks for that. Cheers. Listen, congratulations on the show. So, a little bit about what Marco Polo is all about, because the official blurb is exotic martial arts, political skulduggery, spectacular battles, and sexual intrigue, which sort of sounds like a normal weekend out anyway. But, so what is your take on the show? What's it all about? Anybody.
Okay. Yes, we have hold this, and this is great. I mean, from the script. First of all, the good thing is a true story that nobody knows. And that's great, because we are telling about Mongolia in the medieval era. So what is about? What people, cultures, costumes? We don't know anything. We were so, like now, so focused on us, on the West. And so we are talking about this guy, 17 years old, walking from Venice to the middle of China with his father, and then he spent 20 years old with the most powerful man that they have ever seen.
Kublai Khan, who is the grandson of Genghis Khan and ruler of a fifth of the world landmass. And it just feels like it's a real sort of untapped area, and when West meets East at its most powerful.
Yeah, because as you said, you know, there's such a... People know the name, but there's a lack of knowledge and awareness about what it's all really about.
Yeah.
But it's really exciting as well to discover what these people and what these cultures are like. So, yes, you have a very particular, particularly special relationship. So you arrive in the court, and you're obviously in charge, as you said. So so what can we look forward to in terms of your relationship and how it pans out?
Well, it's something about how Marco has this ability to this... perception, power of his perception, and just his kind of his intuition, that something that really sort of strikes with Kublai, that he has his court, and he feels like he's kind of his own sort of personal CCTV at some point.
That's true.
His eyes and his ears, and he needs that for someone who's at the top, and he's kind of battling with traditional Mongols who are annoyed at the fact that the way he's expanding and sort of turning into kind of more sort of Chinese culture.
And I would say that, you know, a young guy referring to a big king is always a beautiful thing for the king, you know, to have someone honest with him and can really report with fresh eyes his world and his people.
Well, as I said, the first two episodes, I've seen those, they're excellent. Really looking forward to the rest. And obviously, action plays a major role in it. So I've got a bit of an action dilemma for the pair of you, because I've seen you in action already. Hopefully your character, Marco Polo, will obviously grow into it more. But would you rather fight 100 duck-sized horses or one horse-sized duck? So if you're in a battle, rather fight one giant...
I love this question. Yeah? I've been studying for this answer years.
Okay. Well, this is your moment to shine, Lorenzo,
so exactly.
Don't
so
mess
my
it
theory,
up, all right?
My theory is one big duck, because you remember the dodo, the Australian animal? Mm-hmm. Yes, they are weak and they are fluffy, so you can easily get a spike in that.
Spike a dodo or a duck. Yeah. Benedict, would you go for the same
one?
Same tactical analysis
big,
as well,
big,
yeah?
Big duck.
Big duck.
Yeah.
But I would say you have more fun with 100 duck.
It's not about fun. You got to fight them off.
Yeah,
they're there to kill you.
That's why. Survivalism. So yes, big duck.
And finally, as you can probably tell, I came up with most of these questions on the toilet. But what do you like to read when you're relaxing in the bathroom?
Well, YouTube. Come on now. I'm a new generation guy. I'm a modern guy.
Okay. No reading. Just YouTube. The trailer for Marco Polo.
Yeah. No. Oh, that's not appropriate.
Benedict?
What do I do? I rarely bathe, yeah, so it's, I'm just, no.
end of night job done.
Yeah, just, you know, watching something on the tablet, really. Yeah.
Sorted. Yeah. Listen, thanks for the prize earlier on, and congratulations on the
show.
Keep it.
Thanks, man.
Cheers.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks.